Can spray foam insulation be done in cold weather? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about if spray foam insulation can be done in cold weather. Well, this topic comes up a lot, especially this time of year in the cold season. Short answer is yes, it can. The main issue comes up is when we're talking about closed cell spray foam, specifically closed cell spray foam on a surface like metal or cinder block or concrete that gets really cold and stays cold for a while. The problem is that when you spray closed cell insulation onto something like steel, let's say a pole barn for example, and it's super cold, you have yielding problems and you potentially can have adhesion problems also. What that means basically is the product will not expand as much and it potentially may not stick to the surface. Now, there are some techniques in that an experienced spray company can use to get the job done. However, it adds a lot of complications. Next thing we want to talk about is how does this affect you as the customer? Before we talk about that though, go below, hit that like button. Thank you. So, how does it affect you as the customer? Well, for one, if you choose to have closed cell done in a colder season on something like metal, you have to expect that the job itself will take much longer. It's gonna take longer to prep the job. It's gonna take longer just to simply spray the job. A lot of times in these situations, it takes multiple passes to get the depth of foam that you need. And sometimes you have to do something like a flash coating just to get foam to stick to the surface as well. Essentially, you're warming up the surface with the foam. And that takes a lot of time. With that being said, we've talked about it adds a lot of time and a lot of material for the contractor. Obviously, that can add a lot of cost. So as a customer, you want to be prepared for that. And that leads us into our next point. What can you do as the customer to be prepared? Well, you should plan ahead. Have that conversation with your contractor. If you have a project coming up where you know it's closed cell material being sprayed onto a surface like metal or concrete, then have that conversation. Ask him, hey, is this gonna be an issue? What do you plan to do? What should I be prepared for? If you plan for a one-day project, there's a chance it might roll into a second day. There's a chance that they're gonna go through much more material. One of the main reasons you want to have this conversation up front is because you hate to get hit with that awkward conversation at the end of the project with a contractor coming up to you saying, hey, we used a lot more material than we planned for your project. It's going to be X amount of dollars more than what I originally proposed. No one enjoys that conversation, the contractor or the customer. Avoid that awkwardness. Front that off at the pass. Get in front of that and ask them, hey, what should we expect here? The other thing is, plan ahead in the sense that try to avoid having that install done during the cold season. If you can afford it, if your project can account for it, have that done before or after cold season. You can avoid all that, all those questions, all those possibilities, all those anomalies by just moving your schedule a little bit. I understand sometimes that's not doable, and in that case, go back to the previous points of addressing those questions up front with your contractor. Again, an experienced contractor will have some tips and tricks that will help get the job done. Just know it will probably take a little bit longer. It will definitely take more material, and there is a decent chance that the cost may go up, but make sure you have that conversation on the front end. Hope this information was helpful to you. If you have a project coming up that you absolutely need done in the winter season, drop us a comment, talk to us about it. We'd love to help you out, give you some tips. Don't forget, subscribe to this channel and ring that bell so you see all of our notifications. Want to learn more about foam insulation for your pole barn? Check out these other educational videos. Click right there.